Today we're going to talk about a unique problem that now is occurring with the SKR version 2. Now I have two boards on the table, and what I'm basically going to explain to you is there's now a new difference between the boards, and that is the actual MCU, which is the center processor over here and here. The new boards that are now being released have an STM32F429 MCU, whereas the old ones have an STM32F407. So I'm going to show you how to deal with this. So essentially, we're going to go over to the actual desktop of my computer in a second, and I'll walk you through the problem. So essentially, what we're going to see is that when we're over here on the repositories, we're going to have to search for this chipset being STSKR-2. And we'll click on this. And inside here, there'll be a little note that tells you what's going on. So as you can see, due to the shortages of MCUs being this, SKR has two versions with STM32F407 and STM32F429, which is down here. So in order to deal with this, we're going to actually have to go over to the Marlin website. Now, as you can see right here on the Marlin website, the latest release is 2.0.9.2. So in order to actually see what's going on with that, we're going to have to download this and also download the bug fix. Now, this is a development branch, so this may not be super stable, but eventually they'll roll the changes into 2.0.9.2.1 or 2.3. I don't know yet. I actually don't work for Marlin, just so you know. So I've already downloaded both of them, so I'm going to show you real quick what's going on. So over on the actual download that I've done, I've already extracted the bug fix, so I'm going to show you how to extract this real quick. So I'm going to click on extract, and inside here I'm going to say extract for the 2.0 version. Now this might take a second to actually extract, but what you should know is that we're going to actually open these both in VS Code in just a moment. So I'm going to show you something on the Marlin webpage that you may not know about. They have something called release notes, which you can read on the actual downloads that they place up here for you, so you can see the changes. And they also have reporting issues. Now you can search on issues here that occur on your board, like the TMC2209. Now if you search on this, you may see an issue or may not, but usually, if you just place an enter in there, it'll show you what the actual issues are that are occurring with particular types of steppers. Now, there may be other things you can search on, like BL Touch. And this is a good way to actually get information on what is occurring. Now, there's going to obviously be some new builds coming out soon. So what we're going to do now is go over to VS Code, and we're going to look at first the actual configuration for the Marlin 2.0, not the bug fix. So we're going to click on Marlin 2.0, Marlin 2.0, and select the folder. Inside of here, you can see that our platform IO currently for our default environment is not the chipset that we're working with. So what we're going to do is find that real quick. So if we go over here to the INI, and we go to STM32F4, and then we search on SKR_2, we'll find the chipset for STM32F407. Now, we don't see anything for the 429 in here, so we know this is probably not going to be useful. So I'm going to close out of this and show you where it is in bug fix. So I'm going to click on the Explorer, Open Folder, Then I'm going to go to my downloads folder, then go to bug fix, and then select folder. Inside of here, I'm going to then click on the Marlin folder, the source folder, the core folder, and then boards.h. Inside here, I'm going to search on the actual chipset being SKR_V2. And as you can see, there's two different versions. And that has to do with they actually made changes, and this is the newest one that exists. And this should be the only one you use. But I did do a basics tutorial, which I'll place in the upper right-hand corner of this tutorial now so you can watch it. But for now, I'm just going to show you the basic build. So I'm going to copy that, minimize core source, go to configuration.h. I'm going to search on motherboard. I'm going to replace the RAMPS board with our board. Then I'm going to change the serial port to -1. And then I'm going to go back over to the platformio.ini. I'm then going to search inside the ini folder again for STM32F. And I'm going to search on SKR_2. And as you can see in this one, we've got the Bigtree Tech SKR2_F429 for our chipset over here, as you can see. So I'm going to highlight this and copy it. Then I'm going to minimize that folder, go back over to platformio.ini. I'm then going to paste that in for our default environment. I'm then going to click clean, and then I'm going to click build. But before they do that, I'm actually going to go back over to the desktop so you can see the actual change that I need to do for loading. So on the desktop, I'm going to grab the actual SD card. Now this is a 32 gigabit drive, so I've never tried this before. So I'm going to place it in my card reader, and I'm then going to place this in my computer. So you may hear a beep. Now what I'm going to do is go back over to the computer, and on the computer, I'm going to click the build button, and this may take a moment to actually build. Now, if it does fail, you'll see like a red mark come up and that it failed. Try clicking the build button a second time right here, because sometimes there's a cascade of issues that occur with building things out of order. If you see it after the second time, find the very first error that occurs and correct it, then rebuild. So as you can see, it's building inside of here. So in a moment, we should see the firmware.bin as we do now. So what I do is I right click on this. I say reveal in File Explorer. Inside File Explorer, I'm going to then place it on my drive that should be formatted with, I believe, FAT or FAT32, but I usually just leave it alone out of the box. So I'm going to send it to that drive. Then I can check that it's actually there. As you can see, it now resides there. So I'm going to go back over to the desktop and try and load this. So I'm going to pull out the drive. I'm then going to place the drive in the SD card reader right here. Now, there may be an issue with me powering it with the actual USB from the computer for the serial cable. So I'm going to plug this in and check. Now, it's not powering up, so you need direct power in this case on your ports. But for now, what we're going to do is move the jumper over just so we can power the board. You don't want to use this position for special steppers like TMC type steppers. And this should power the board to load the firmware. So if we hear a ding, it means the firmware did load. So what we're going to do next is we're actually going to go over to the computer and test this in Pronterface to see if we can connect. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up Pronterface in just a second, so you can actually see this. So over in Pronterface, I'm going to try and connect to it. Now it says COM port 1. So one of the things that may occur is you're going to have to go to the device manager, which I'll show you this real quick. So inside of device manager, we're going to search on it by typing device, then press enter, and it should come up on your screen. And we're going to go to ports, and you can see it's serial port 5 for the COM port. So we're just going to click over here, select 5. You can also highlight it and actually add it in yourself, then click connect. Now it says connecting printer is now online. So one of the tests you can run, if you want to see if it sees the end stops, you can type M119. Now we have none connected, so they're probably all going to say triggered, which they do. So we know we're connected to that board. Now I need to take a moment to thank all my patrons for liking, subscribing, and also helping to offset the costs on both Patreon and PayPal. So I'll be rolling at the end of this a thank you note for them. And thank you very much. Have a nice day. Be safe, get vaccinated, and wear a mask.